Hello and welcome to our live coverage from the National Football Stadium at Windsor Park. This is Northern Ireland's premier competition for under-19 clubs and players, the Harry Cavan Youth Cup, which is a Mid-Ulster affair. Dungannon Swiss and Glenavon. Going 2-2. To see who will be taking the trophy down the road after all is said and done. We can bring you the team news from Dungannon Swiss. First of all, it's going to be a 4-3-3 for them. Grugan is in goals, McDade, Francis, O'Kane and Saldana the back four. Two, Scott and Lynch will be the three in the middle of the park. Kearney and Tavares will flank Jimenez in attack. Dungannon Swiss have never won this competition before. Will they be able to change that fact here at Windsor Park? And for the Lurgan Blues, it would appear they're matching them formation-wise. Another 4-3-3. Ferris and Goulds, Harvey, Lynch, Purdy and Gill in the back line. Ingram, who scored in under a minute in the semi-final, that was rather remarkable. Hoping he can have a similar type of impact tonight if he can, alongside Black and Norton in midfield. And Corr, Prendergast and McGreevy. Couchman are their front line. Glenavon last won the cup in 2015. It's been a while. They'd love to do it again, that goes without saying. Captains chatting with the refs. We'll tell you about the officials in a moment. These are the subs. Murphy, McNally, Somerville, Crewe and Donnelly for Dungannon Swifts in all yellow for this one. Traditionally the senior team's away kit, but it's the preferred kit for Dungannon Swifts. Glenavon are very much in what has become their home kit this season. A bit more white than traditionalists might like in that jersey, but I think everyone's got used to it by now. The referee is Ben Shepherd. He leads a suitably youthful panel of officials. He's only 20 years of age, and that makes him the oldest person with a whistle or a flag here. Yes, the rest are either 18 or 19. Doesn't that just make you feel wonderful? Kira Lappin and Aaron Rainey, his assistants. The fourth official is Fintan Coyle, and it goes without saying we wish them the very best of luck for this one. Most of the formalities out of the way, now just the final checks, and then we can get going. Massive amount of excitement coming into this one. The Derby feel adding to the atmosphere. And one feature that you might have already noticed, and if you haven't, you will, is the higher numbers on their jerseys. Just the sort of thing commentators love to keep an eye on. This Swifts team have been playing against under-20s all season. Such is the talent within the ranks. You imagine that is the sort of footing that can stand you in good stead in the final. The Glenavon panel are a mix of age groups, really, but that doesn't make them any less gifted as they try and conjure up an early attack. Runners moving into the centre. That cross blocked well by Saldana. He's trying to deny that ball coming in. Stabbed into the centre, and it's going to be a comfortable one. First touch of the night for Adam Grugan. And he wastes no time in trying to free Tavares. Skill, not in any rush to give the ball back there. He jogs back into position as Dungannon Swifts prepare the throw-in. Possession lost. Pass inside. Did find someone in his own colours, but they weren't able to keep a hold of the ball, and it's a lovely bit of trickery there in the finish. Wasn't a bad one. Shea Ferris relieved to see it come straight down on top of him in the end, but it was Kenny Jimenez with a bit of skill that got him in behind. Well, in talking about players getting opportunities, Glenavon certainly were prepared to throw several of these young lads into the first team. A chance to play against Warren Point Town at the final stage of the Premiership season on Saturday. Always a good opportunity to test out some of your young stars and see who might be able to make that step up in the next year or two. And I'm sure that some of those tuning in for this match tonight will be casting an eye over the players as well, wondering might they be an addition for their ranks at some stage. Keeper coming all the way, bravely taking charge of that one. Big call from Ferris. Defender knew where he was and was able to allow him to get in before Jimenez. That was well recovered by Oran O'Kane. I was wondering, was he aware that the man on call wasn't quite forthcoming as the ball is played through, nipping away, trying to make the challenge and not shy in being physical there, but it's a brilliant bit of play in the pass, now moving out wide as John Savage's young charges come forward, but they weren't able to put the cross in that they were hoping for, and that gives the Swifts a reprieve. Both managers speaking before the game, saying about the challenge of selecting a panel of 16, not in terms of trying to fill it, but in terms of who might miss out. And one thing that they both were in agreement of was that the Irish Football Association, a lovely gesture from them, allowing them to bring the full complement of players, so even if they weren't in the match day squad, they could still be part of the final experience so as to not miss out. That was a decent ball across the box, wasn't it? Kearney was the player swinging and missing a boot in the area. That is a good cross. That looked like a sore clash of heads. Chris Gill was the player coming in for the ball, and I think the referee wisely is just going to make sure that both are okay before continuing. Hasty delivery in. Eyes on the ball the whole way, but that looked a sore one. Minimal fuss from both, it has to be said. Straightforward free kick award there. Body check right in front of the referee. And the Swifts not wasting any time spraying it forwards. And pacey though he might be, Jamal Tavares was not going to be able to keep that one in this time. Little glance around to see who's there. Glenavon do have options, but they're being pressed high at the moment. It is the side in all yellow who will be happier with their start, with just over 8 minutes played. New name on the trophy guaranteed. Cliftonville Strollers were the holders. They fell at the semi-final stage this time. Losing out on penalties against Dungannon Swifts, and that challenge is going to be one that's scrutinised by the referee, and he might want a further conversation there. It certainly was a forceful challenge. And it's just a talking to here. It might come across on our stream, but I have to confess that the Glenavon numbers are almost impossible to read from this height on that kind of colouring. Bring back the days of solid colours on one another. The Dungannon kit, you can see from a mile off, not just because it is bright yellow, but the kind of blue on blue, not advantageous. We'll do our best with it anyway. Back there, quickly swarming in the middle of the park, Glenavon. Firm challenge coming in as they creep up the park and try and just get it taken a little quicker there. Not able to find a way through yet, but it might open up for them here. Wanted to move that onto his right side for a moment. The left back maybe surprised to find himself in the penalty area. That's been a feature, in fairness, of their route to the final, the high goal scoring. 7 against Rosario, 9 against Ballyclare Comrades, 4 against Carrick Rangers, 5 against Glentoran, and they were hoping to find a way through there, but not able to, as Grugan goes sweeper keeper and sprays the angled ball all the way to the opposing keeper in the end. Lovely stuff. Nearly worked away inside as well. Maybe just starting to grow in confidence. Glenavon with the corner. Punched into the sky. Not dealt with yet. And they do well to squeeze high there. Handed a note a moment ago that said you might have been able to hear some of our crew talking. If that was the case, I do apologise. Hopefully we've resolved that issue for you now as we see the Swifts settle for the corner. Fifteen minutes gone. Glenavon having to defend this set piece. Inswinger coming in too, going to meet it. Well, they thought they could get out there. The shot charged down, and now they might have a chance to counter-attack. Head up, thinking fast for the pass. Calmly watched by McDade, and it's well turned by Tavares, who's going to try and get a run on the fullback. Little flick just took it over the head of the defence. They're all back in there at the moment. Harvey, Lynch, Purdy, Gill trying to keep things tight. Referee thought about for a second, but maybe grabbing the ball helped him make his mind up. Free kick awarded. Hanging in the air. Difficult one, that. As it proved to be. Well, an extra player in the box. And they could have been looking at a tap in there, Glenavon. Oh. How to create space where there was none. That was very nicely done. That pass not quite matching the quality that went before it. Always interesting seeing how different teams adapt to playing on a big pitch such as this one. And also managing the occasion, friends and family among the spectators in the stand underneath us here. Waiting on the game's first goal. The flag very quickly up. Assistant referee spotting that run going just a fraction too early. Nice vision. Accompanying run there, but quickly had his avenue closed off. You don't see many of those anymore, do you? Good old-fashioned diving header. Just couldn't divert it between the sticks. Jimenez was the player stretching to meet it, but it was comfortably wide, and Ferris didn't break a sweat. Second pass had the added power that the first one was missing. Made it bread and butter for the defence. I think he managed to style out that slip. Brought under control. Still he runs, and that was going in. A wonderful bit of play. They are not out of the woods yet, and that was well held by Ferris. It's a fantastic save from him too, having to stretch out and get a strong hand on it after Tavares cut inside and was hoping to find the far corner. Well, he's a little unlucky there, isn't he, Paul? Did bounce up and strike a hand. Just a bit of a heavy touch there, wasn't it? Options running out. And maybe a bit of patience running out there too. Swifts weren't necessarily happy with the robust way in which he looked after himself there, the young Glenavon player, but the initial infringement given against Dungannon Swifts. Prendergast, McGravy, Couchman amongst those lurking, hoping a ball might drop for them. Thinking McGreevy Couchman giving the pass and making that run, just not able to get it back again. They've had to be patient with their play and maybe could benefit from a little more patience. Easy said, I know, from up here. Swift's well organised, I think, that Chris McCann will be happy by and large with what he has seen. First year in the job for him. His team defending at the moment. Little speculative there. Grugan happy to watch that one sail over the crossbar. Chris McCann takes the under-20s successor to Dixie Robinson, who became the head of youth development for Dungannon Swifts. And McCann closely works with the first team boss, Dean Shields, who, as Saturday has proven, takes an interest in these players. Not that keepers ever have an easy night, but when you see the pace of the front three that are there for the Swifts, it certainly means Ferris has to be certain when he's coming, and so far, to his credit, he's made those decisions and made them well. Cries of don't foul him coming from the bench. Sage advice from Savage and Co. The challenge again. Don't think any complaints there. Just sold him short. Head tennis, confusion. And in the end, the confusion has led to a penalty. Jimenez was hoping to steal in. And Ferris, in making the challenge, adjudged to have committed the foul. Well, he was put in a difficult position, wasn't he, when the header didn't come back in time. And now, as he shows us his agility, he will try and deny Oran O'Kane. But he cannot deny him. It was a confidently struck penalty swept in. And Ferris was sent the wrong way. As we get the first goal in this year's Harry Cavan Youth Cup final. Dungannon Swifts 1, Glenavon 0. The Lurgan Blues trying to encourage one another to pick themselves back up. They've had to weather a bit of a storm. I thought they had improved as the half had gone on, and then to concede a goal in a bit of a disappointing fashion, really, cheaply given away, and they won't want to make matters worse for themselves here. Ably defended. Core dropping the shoulder, getting the run on his man, and that's a great ball, and it should have been a leveller. Just couldn't reach it at the far post. Almost an immediate response. That was very well done. Core clattered. And Lewis Francis will get a talking to. Thou shalt not pass. And nor did he. Lovely little disguise initially. Letting the ball roll through his legs as he turned and sprinted. And now, having gone close a moment ago with that cutback that couldn't find the killer touch, can they provide a moment to give their fans something to cheer for? Hit it well. Core got decent height and bend on it, but Grugan didn't have to move too much to tip it over. Lots of movement in the middle. Who will get ahead to it? Well, it dropped rather perilously, but punted away. Maybe a little bit of nerves for the first time being shown by the Swifts after a very good response to going behind for Glenavon. Long way to go in this match yet. Good move, trying to do it himself. I thought it was decent defending. O'Kane's penalty so far the difference with 34 minutes gone. Minutes until the break. What a second goal would do for the Swifts. And conversely, how desperate Glenavon will be to prevent that. Certainly, penalty appeal waved away by the referee, and I would go as far as saying correctly there, don't think there was really much of a shout for one. If anything, they did well to keep the move alive. For Glenavon, a bit of a balancing act in some ways, isn't it? They want to get back in an even keel, but they do not want to leave themselves wide open and be hurt at the other end. Advantage given. And that will be offside. The pass played by two, but Jimenez had already gone. And they're going to halt proceedings and just come back and check on the welfare of the player who took a bit of a bump a moment ago, which was Lewis Francis. Allows one or two players to have a conversation, figure out what they want to do more of or differently. Well laid off, wasn't it? Again, able to hold it up well in and around the 18-yard box. And somewhat limited to shots and anger from distance. Glenavon maintaining their shape. Six players in and around defending, and they're grateful for those numbers as they're able to spoon that cross away, albeit temporarily. McDeed and Jimenez couldn't generate the neck power. Gave possession back a little cheaply. As did that. this combination of passes initially. Just not able to find one in the final third, where options have been a little more limited due to the defensive diligence of their opponents, but that may fall kindly for them here if they can keep it in. Kaur, he's been one of the standout players from Savage's team, by my reckoning, in this first half. Halves are 45 minutes each way, which you may be aware of, but not everybody's sure of these things at different levels. I can assure you that is the case here. That is a foul as well. That's quite a clear one. And the referee shows the yellow card. Norton with the booking, just getting confirmation of that. The younger brother of Robbie Norton, of course, who's on loan this season with Anna, hoping to seal promotion to the Premiership. Anna United, big game in store for them on Friday, the second leg against Portadown, trailing 3-2 from the first match. I'm sure he'll have an eye on how his siblings faring. About taking that shot on, and then there was a heavy touch, and the challenge which came after it certainly left its mark. Players higher here, Glenavon, towards the end of this first half. Just leaving two men back at times as they push the numbers on. 2.5 minutes until the break, plus whatever additional time the fourth official allocates for us. Composed play there could have caused issues. Lovely bit of hold up play too, but the runner in behind went the other direction from the pass. Haven't been able to quite work that combination as they would normally do, Prendergast and McGreevy Coachman. And when that is the case, in many ways, that's a compliment to how people have been defending. Referee just waiting a moment to see if play would develop there. And then some were wondering whether it might have been more beneficial to allow an advantage, but decision made. As soon as they get the ball back, that is. It will be a free kick. Fourth official emerging with the board. And there will be just the 1 minute of added time here at the National Football Stadium at Windsor Park. Chris McCann will be thinking, so far so good. Little sign of frustration there. No great rush to take this. The play gets back underway now. First glance at the watch from the ref. Half almost on the blue. Might just want to see if at all this develops any further. But there is no more time, and that will call an end to the action in what has been a tight first half. A few good chances, but we'll recap you on the goal in a moment from the spot, and that is what separates them so far. The halftime score: Dungannon Swifts 1, Glenavon 0. As we cast our mind back to some of the brighter moments of the first half. Jimenez showing some skill early on. And then trying to turn back the years with a diving header. Not something the modern forward does as much of. It was the turn of Tavares to step through defenders and try and stroke that one delightfully beyond Ferris, who did ever so well to stretch and save. But he had a penalty awarded against him for that challenge after the header back sold him short, and Oran O'Kane made it look easy from the spot. Coors running down the left, nearly brought an almost immediate equaliser for Glenavon, and that was their best opportunity. We have 45 minutes still to play, and the prospect potentially, we should remember, of extra time and penalties if they are to be required, but as things stand, they're not. It's Dungannon Swifts 1, Glenavon 0 at the break. Hello and welcome back to our second half here at the National Football Stadium at Windsor Park. Dungannon Swifts 1-0 up against Glenavon in the Harry Cavan Youth Cup final. A big 45 minutes which will determine which way the cup is going. The Swifts have the advantage. Will they be able to hold on to it or add to it? Or might Glenavon find a way back into this contest? Just the one goal, of course. I have to take my hat off to the Glenavon media team, by the way, at halftime. We're having a discussion about how hard the numbers are to read from a million miles away when you've blue on blue. And we went through in great detail the colour of everybody's boots, and we've just noticed one of them has changed their boots. So it's not very helpful, but it does actually help me. So McGreevy Couchman, I do believe now, in the luminous orange boots. That's some shot, isn't it? Packed a punch, was rising, but just off target. The things you have to do, honestly, as a commentator, these are all part of it, but the Glenavon guys have been great help, as have Dungannon in the build-up to the match, just to make sure nobody misinterprets the message there. In many ways, difficult to know what type of match we were going to get with, you know, Dungannon Swifts in the Premiership Development League, finished fourth, four places and 9 points ahead of Glenavon, but it's not exactly the same team from a Glenavon perspective, whereas it more or less is from Dungannon Swifts, so you can't quite measure like for like in terms of their league campaigns. But the Swifts have edged the game so far. Brilliant bit of close control that from Kearney. Wasn't able to get the cross he was after. Another chance to get involved in the action here. Hopping away from the challenges. The return pass just a little overplayed. And Harvey clearing his lines at the expense of a throw-in. Glenavon on the defensive. Kearney won the aerial duel. No nonsense defending. Ferris wanted that on his right boot, was able to put a bit of distance on it. Gill. Strong header from Francis defending his area. Prendergast earns the free kick. He came to the club last year. He's flying in terms of form. Got first team exposure on Saturday. Limited in terms of goal scoring opportunities falling his way at this stage in the match. Inside the 5th minute of the second half. Possession turned over on the defence. Could have been stretched, but that's strong and fair from Lynch. Able to edge his man out of the way, and Prendergast thought he had got clear of Saldana, who did well with the covering challenge, and well, Prendergast hasn't popped back up to his feet. Maybe just felt a twinge as the challenge came in. Hopefully he'll be able to run that off. Only a throw-in. Don't need to tell you that wasn't the intended direction. Goalkeeper to the rescue. Grugan sticking it in the stands. Well, they've managed to make it through a very congested area well, and that call came in, so they were able to leave the ball run. Lynch has continued his run. Tavares is backing himself and blasting from range, but sending it over. Well, Dummy initially giving them the impression they were going for the far post, in the end pulling it back, hoping for a late runner, which wasn't forthcoming on that occasion. That was strong but fair. That looked close to being offside, and the flag after a moment is raised. Aaron Rainey just took a moment to think about it, but the flag came up, and Glenavon deemed to have held their line well. Well, he wasn't quite able to manoeuvre himself away from the challenges. That was a thundering one. Prendergast. That will be a free kick. Oh, much to my surprise it isn't. It seemed pretty cut and dry, but not given. Well, you can see it again here. It wasn't the best pass, but he certainly steps between the ball and the challenging player, and would have thought that a free kick would have been a nailed-on conclusion. Not the case. Bradley Ingram will be making way. And Dylan Sinnerton is on. Sinnerton was an unused sub at the weekend. Happy to get on and be involved in the final here. Will he be able to help change the fortunes of Glenavon? Prendergast trying to get in. He was drawn in there by Scott, who was able to dribble away. Some very technically gifted players in this Swifts team. Do play lovely football, but they have given away a free kick in a dangerous area. Does allow a few more players from the back to be sent forwards here. Glenavon hoping for a good delivery. The Swifts making sure they pick up their markers. Certainly nothing wrong with the ball in. The last touch off of Glenavon head and behind harmlessly for a goal kick. Well, there's a player running onto it. Not much wrong with that, but defenders doing their job, not allowing a free run in the end in the area. He's done very well here. Tavares. Just not able to reach anybody in yellow. Just a couple of signs that the game is stretching a little more. Slower tempo to this one, very deliberate, both teams in their actions. Decent hand shown by the ball boy there. McGreevy Couchman couldn't meet that one, but he's still an option. They're looking over the top of the defence instead, and it skips up off the turf for Grugan. Lynch flicked it on. Jimenez was trying to spin his marker, but safely back with Ferris. I think a few from Glenavon's bench were hoping to see where that might advance to, but they have the free kick. Comes in, it was left, and McGreevy Couchman closed down quickly as he tried to get the snapshot. That was a big call from Grugan, heard it up here in the gods. Jimenez springs so quickly back to his feet. Wasn't able to do that the second time. And then the ball played off Saldana to give Glenavon the goal kick. Again, you just wonder if set plays might bring about a bit more fortune for Glenavon. Not always winning the first ball, but the second balls are there to be contested, and McGreevy Couchman had a chance, but really only a half chance the way he was closed down. A couple of players slipping, maybe just the way the pitch was watered earlier on, is it? Making it difficult underfoot at times. Core. His tricky runs were a feature in the first half. His delivery dropping between men from his team and into the gloves of Grugan. Set up for a nervy final 30 minutes here. Still the goal from the captain, Orin O'Kane. That divides the teams. He made his first start for the senior team. Played the whole game against Ballymena United. Shows you the faith that they have in him. He most certainly is one of the attractions as well of this competition and competitions like it. The chance to see some of the emerging talent from across the country. As Glenavon get their heads down, get forward. And McGreevy Couchman in behind, he wants it himself. And Prendergast looks flabbergast in the centre. Well, we know the senior team likes to play out from the back. Maybe that's part of the thinking there too. Keep the defenders beside the keeper. Let them try it if they want to. They elected not to on this occasion. A couple of appeals for a foul, which were not listened to. The run into the box is a really good one. And I have to say the balance as well. Because it looked as if he was tumbling over. He found a way to thread the ball through the legs of the defender. And in the end, it was just a numbers game that stopped a shot on goal being allowed there. Great energy being shown by both parties there in that tussle. The Swifts trying to hold on to their lead as they watch this one come in. Met at the front post. Not out of the woods yet. Oh, they're looking for an offside. The flag will stay down this time, and this could be the second goal. He's round the keeper. And Jimenez doubles Dungannon Swift's advantage. It could well be decisive. Glenavon were caught on the counter-attack. And they looked across the line. Desperate to see a flag came up. It didn't. And from here, he did brilliantly. Drew the keeper out. Went around him. And rounded off the move. With his first goal in the final, his team second, and now both sides will make changes. Cormac McNally will be introduced momentarily. But before that, it's going to be Patrick Shearer coming on. And look at McGreevy Couchman. You can see he's disappointed as he makes his way off. Shea Kearney, the player, heading off for Cormac McNally. I'm remembering right as well, McNally was at Glenavon at one stage. Well, it does make it a little more obvious what is needed. At a goal down, you might sit back and think, We can shadow box for a bit before we land our big punch, but at two, you really just have to go for it. And that will play into the hands, potentially, of Dungannon Swifts, depending on how this next period of play goes. An uphill task now for Glenavon. And this is how quickly they were able to turn defence into attack, and it does look so tight there, doesn't it? The flag stayed down. Round the keeper he went. And into the net it went. Dungannon Swifts 2, Glenavon 0 in the Harry Cavan Youth Cup final. Decent ball in. McDeed got his head to it. Gill was competing for it. And again, they just split from the pack. And that one's going to be offside. And he knew it as he checked his run. Kenny Jimenez had just ventured a little too far forwards. Such a difficult one when you're trying to play an offside trap against people so fast, because they just need the benefit of the doubt once against you, and they get in. Challenge coming in from behind there. Not complicated for the referee, Ben Shepherd. Lynch gave the pass, got it back, and then couldn't find the next one. That was a strong coming together there. Play continues. I think it's safe to say some of these players are fired up. Youthful exuberance, but they would need to be ever so careful. Mistime that, and their experience of a final may end prematurely. Good hands again by Grugan. When called upon, he has looked very assured. Arrowed that pass wonderfully to Scott as well, didn't he? Glenavon were convinced that was going to be their throw. Flag's gone the other way, but maybe just a bit of crump. A couple of players taking this opportunity to stretch out. Whilst treatment is being administered, we can see that second goal again. They were hoping to see an offside flag. Jimenez lightning pace, just herd away. Ran in one-on-one and applied the killer touch. This was, you know, in hindsight, a big chance for them too, potentially. Not a clear-cut one, but it's been that sort of night for Glenavon. McGreevy Coachman from an angle, and then the run through even then. It is really a testament to how well Dungannon Swifts have defended, because when you think they've left a bit of room in behind, all of a sudden three players appear from nowhere to deny an opportunity. Play will get back underway in a moment. We can see Lynn Carpenter, the physio, making her way back across the pitch. And we might be getting another substitution in a moment here, because I'm not so sure that he'll be able to continue, unfortunately. The body language suggests not. So that will be the end of Liam Corr's night, as Daniel Dillon replaces him. So that is all of Glenavon's subs used. Five named, and a maximum of three can be used in normal time. What a goal might do for their confidence. The work rate again of Dungannon Swifts is to be admired. They really have been mean-spirited in terms of their defending, not allowing any opportunities really. And Cormac McNally was the player trying to wriggle away. Referee has awarded the free kick. Well, it's been a pretty accomplished display from Chris McCann and his players. They've done their best to control the game to minimise the threat. And the game plan is working. Prendergast will allow that to be retrieved as he stays in the centre. Good work from Chris Gill. That was a late challenge. Little step over there. And now they're asking for a free kick, and the offside flag has come up instead. Well, contrasting views on that one. You have a goalkeeper who applauds the decision, and a couple of Glenavon players who are sharing their own views on things. Maybe this will give us a better idea. Certainly wasn't going to be an offside there. No. If anything, a free kick could have been called. Just whilst we're watching that player, the latest to experience a bit of cramp. I've heard of multi-ball. I've never seen multi-bottle before. A few of the players taking refreshments, and one was nearly clobbered as everyone tried to offer him a drink. Turns out there's a fine art to keeping our young stars hydrated. There's going to be a substitution made here. Ryan Donnelly is stripped off and ready to come on. And And Jamal Tavares will be the player to make way. Well, the change announced, we just have to wait for the injured Tavares to hobble off first of all before they can allow Donnelly to come on. Ready and raring to go with 13 and a half minutes left of this final. Chance for him to get a little bit of final instruction from his manager, Chris McCann. So the change now confirmed. Tavares, through injury, to play no more part. And the way he's been running up and down the pitch, it's no wonder that he is exhausted at this stage. Hopefully that's just a cramp and nothing more severe, as Jimenez was trying to immediately get Donnelly involved in the action. Prendergast was clipped as he stepped away from his marker. Well, the body language on the pitch and on the bench as well would give you an indicator as to how they're feeling. No surprise it aligns with the score. Things not going Glenavon's way. Football has a wonderful way of never feeling fair when you're losing. Minutes to go. Chris McCann. Is close. Now to the promised land. Well, I was going to say, Chris McCann's thinking about winning what he described as the biggest match of his career, but his keeper was having to make a smart save there. That was a thunderbolt from the blue. Well, it's a miss kick, but he is a long way out, isn't he? And the flying save from Grugan results in this corner. Taken by the left back. Gill gets it in, and the header from Prendergast is past the post. Glenavon's boss, John Savage, is actually himself a Youth Cup winner. As fate would have it, when he won it, it was against the team he is in charge of, back as a young Bangor player. Under the tutelage of Nigel Best, no less. Jimenez is the latest player to stay down. Glenavon continuing their venture forwards here. And they get the throw. Well, they're certainly doing their level best to, at the very least, find a consolation goal, Glenavon. And Dungannon Swifts will make a change here. And I think Jimenez will be the player to make away. Yes, confirmation of that. Oliver Crew comes on. So both teams have used the full complement of subs. McDade able to shadow it out. The Swifts looking to put the icing on the cake if they're able to. In a commanding position, confident that they will be lifting the trophy from this point. The referee might be lifting a card out of his pocket, he will be. Saldana penalised for a poor tackle. He arrived late there. The touch is across, they'll get a goal here. Oh, they won't. They thought it was a way back in. But the flag has come up. That's how you know it's not going to be your night. Prendergast, I think, has just got himself a yellow card there, maybe for something said rather than the challenge. Not able to hold it up there. Dunavon Paul popping off the hip as they try and play it up the line, and the ball deemed to have crossed the line. And look with a tinge of disappointment at the official there. I think they were willing it to stay in more than anything. Harry Norton, the captain, had played the pass forwards, but decision already made there. Little over 4 minutes plus whatever added time we get to go. Does feel like a formality, but Glenavon can point to the fact they've had a goal chalked off in the last couple of minutes as a sign that there is a bit of life still left in them. almost the entire Glenavon squad came through the academy together, which is a sign of how long they've played together and an indicator as to how tight the group would be too. But it looks like the night is ending in disappointment for them, and it will be soon. Celebrations for the Swifts, who, let's remember, have never won the Harry Cavan before, and they are on the verge of doing that. That was a tackle born out of frustration. Just a little word of no more of that, please. Cards not coming out this time. Probably wise as well, with Norton already in a caution. Referee maybe in the spirit of things looking on as the pass comes in behind. Options are available. The Swifts are hoping for a third, and they will find it. It's Saldana who seals it, and they will celebrate with him. Well, he's hobbling, but I'm sure inside he's delighted. Dungannon Swifts 3, Glenavon 0. Well, it was a good delivery across. His run was well timed. And it somewhat squirmed past Ferris. But there was nothing the keeper could do. Sign of the confidence in the ranks, that, wasn't it? O'Kane, happy to invite the pressure and take the cool touch. The Swifts have come through Bangor 4-0, Ards by 2-0, Linfield Rangers 1-0 in the quarter final. As I mentioned earlier, they won 4-3 in penalties. Oh, he's hearing the man of the match. That's been announced as Kenny Jimenez, as we also learn 5 additional minutes have been added. And the latest scalp on the list for the Swifts will be Glenavon, with the score as it is and 5 to go. Glenavon, to their credit, continuing to the end. They far from disgrace themselves. The scoreline doesn't give you the impression that they've put in the performance they have, but Dungannon Swifts have been really, really effective. Played some nice football and shown how clinical they can be. Nice little drag and play there by McNally. All about seeing this out now. The pressure off. As they get ready to have a bit of a party atmosphere. Free kick given there. Niggly challenges, symptomatic of the stage of the game that we have arrived at. That's a bit of quick thinking. It's a lovely touch. You can see he's wanting the shot himself. Wasn't able to do that. Crow moves it on. And that's set up really invitingly for Scott. But the offside flag was up. Lynch, the player, who was judged to have been beyond the last man. Not sure that he was, I must say. Oh, that's fantastic. Lynch has opened this one up. It's a great run. And McNally, well, it looked like he was being held on to, didn't it? Couldn't get the power on the finish. Very honest to stay on his feet after. It looked like there was a little bit of a pullback on his arm. Glenavon's turn to attack. Just wouldn't sit for them again at the far post. They will say, how many times has that been said over the course of the match? Well, that's going to be a free kick. Quite a needless one to concede as well. Coming through the back of his man. And there won't be much left after this to be played. As the organisers ready themselves for the trophy presentation that will follow. The cup that goes all the way back to 1952 will have a new name on it. Glenavon are hoping the scoreboard will have a goal from them on it. And they have got that goal. This one will not be chalked off. Harry Lynch arriving, and it's a really good finish from him. Well played in. He had freed himself of anyone marking him, and he thumped the header in the last meaningful involvement of the match. It is all over. And the celebrations can now begin for the Swifts as Glenavon players sink to the pitch, defeated and depleted of energy. A long and difficult night hasn't gone their way, but for Dungannon Swifts, a stylish performance gives them a 3-1 win at Windsor Park. As the red carpet and the boarding is brought out onto the pitch. All the coaches coming on, embracing, interacting with one another. Great respect shown between camps, but also rivals though they might be. all in good spirits at full time. See the red carpet. They can't wait to walk down on it. They'll have to wait a bit longer. Sophie not ready just yet. Well, looking across the pitch, some players staying down. Let's remind ourselves of the goals from the game. Oran O'Kane with the only goal of the first half from the spot. The captain tucking away his penalty. And Glenavon thought it was them threatening. They were ripped open. That ball finding Kenny Jimenez. He had the burst of pace to beat the keeper and extend their lead. Through all the blue jerseys, the pass reaching Saldana, who stuck out a limb to steer it in. And right before the end, Harry Lynch heading in a consolation goal at the death for the Lurgan Blues. As you can see, the staging making its way out now. Four-man job, that. No pressure with the cameras on them. I'm sure they rehearse these sorts of things up nice and smoothly. The trophy and the medals there too, along with the Man of the Match award, which will be presented, as we know, to Kenny Jimenez. By my estimations, we're almost ready at this stage. Very different conversations, one might imagine, going on between the two huddles of players. One's brimming with joy and one's maybe analysing little moments, the what-ifs of football.
Let's hear it for your Man of the Match for this evening's game. That award is being presented by the chairman of the Junior and Youth Cup Committee, and that goes to Duncan Swift, number 44.
So the chair of the Junior League Cup Committee handing over the Man of the Match award to Kenny Jimenez. One of a number of players who really impressed in Dungannon Swift's colours. Part of that terrifyingly fast
ladies
front
and gentlemen,
three.
Let's hear from your officials next, referee Ben Shepherd, assisted by Kira Lappin.
So next up is our young officials. Ben Shepherd leading the way Fintan Coyle behind him. Aaron Rennie and Kira Lappin. They've all come through the National Referee Academy.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it now for your runners-up, Glenavon.
And a good reception for the runners-up. And one they deserve as well. To be commended for how they kept plugging away when it would have been easy to throw in the towel. Pulled a goal back late on. Kept a bit of pride. And although it's not the medal they were after, it still shouldn't be overlooked what it is to reach a final. Which leaves us, naturally, with the winners.
Ladies and gentlemen, now let's hear it for your winners of your Harry Cavan Youth Cup, Duncan and Swifts.
And as you can hear, they've brought a healthy support along with them as well. Medals first of all. Then take your positions before the captain claims the cup.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's show some appreciation for the Dungannon Swifts captain, Orin O'Kane.
Medal lifted, slung round the neck, cup in hand.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're Harry Cavan.
And now a moment for them to savour. As Dungannon Swifts, for the first time in the club's history, lift the Harry Cavan Youth Cup. A journey that saw them see off Linfield and Cliftonville on their way. Having tasted defeat in the semi-final the last time out, they were galvanised as a club. And in 2022, stand proud as the winners. A great night for all involved with Dungannon Swifts, for manager Chris McCann. His players have proven themselves able. Jay Willis, Mark Hegarty, Terry Fitzpatrick, all part of the coaching setup with the young Swifts. And it's a hearty congratulations to them on their success. Some of the backroom team and other players joining them now as the photographs are taken. It's a collective effort to reach a final. It's a monumental effort to win one. That is what they have done tonight. Dungannon Swifts, your victors, 3-1 here at the National Football Stadium at Windsor Park. Thank you very much for joining us for this one tonight. Treated to four goals in the end. and the Swifts and their supporters will be the ones celebrating for the foreseeable. Until next time, from me and the rest of the team, it's good night and take care. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.